RLF. Wrong life can be lived rightly. With this artistic and simultaneously revolutionary transmedia project, Arte, Zurkamp, UFA, and Project Office Friedrich von Borries have created a playful yet serious critique of capitalism. Between the bank crisis and spying scandals, RLF unflinchingly raises existential questions. But how to start a revolution in an era of intense interconnectivity and global crowdsourcing? RLF sees only one solution. Beat capitalism at its own game. Create a real movement using the mechanics of the system. A unique combination of media and non-media channels transforms RLF into a multidimensional weapon of revolution. It's a novel, an actual company, a game, a film, and enters the real world in the shape of specific events. Think tank, experiment, and political work of art, RLF already caused an enormous press buzz prior to the publication of the novel. Whether on radio, television, in print, or online, a controversial debate about RLF's project has developed throughout the media. But how did the RLF ball get rolling? The novel RLF, with its story of advertising man Jan, who gets caught up in the London riots by accident, is the beginning. From this situation emerges the unique premise of RLF, earning money for the revolution using luxury products. For this new protest movement, Jan recruits the new shareholders of the revolution who are both consumers and activists. He hires artist Michael as the artistic director and activist Slavia as the spiritual leader of RLF. But before the company can really get started, Jan suddenly loses his life in a mysterious accident. Von Borries, who appears as the author of the story, has to reconstruct events using Jan's iPhone, which has been passed on to him. He decides, and now RLF has definitely crashed reality, to become the company's managing director. A cliffhanger at the end of the book leads readers directly to the website rlf-propaganda.com, where the characters pull them into the events surrounding RLF. A conflict unfolds via Slavia's tweets and von Borries's RLF news, and between Slavia's activist ambitions and Friedrich's desire to collect even more money for the RLF Lifestyle Club. To this end, he also enters into cooperations with global players such as Adidas and the highly traditional KPM porcelain manufacturer. Anyone can buy these products, which have already been established as part of the book's storytelling strategy, and as a result, finance the resistance. The actual products have an ironic twist, since they anticipate the collapse of capitalism. For example, the nails with which the dining table and chairs are assembled have gold plating but are not sealed. The value is destroyed by the use. The project's first public appearance takes place at the revolutionary 1st of May demonstrations. Later, the company presents its product range to Berlin's art scene in a former church. To further exploit the world of street fashion and design, these interactions are followed by events in a hip sneaker shop on the famously commercial boulevard Kudamm and inside a high-end concept store. But while Friedrich celebrates the product launch with hundreds of guests, Slavia suddenly storms in with a group of followers to subvert what she sees as the final commercialization of RLF. In the following weeks, Slavia concentrates on the development of RLF and attempts to recruit more followers. Since she and her team already report on current protest movements from around the world via the website's resistance ticker, she urges colleagues to push the networking with full force. Her team distribute critical illustrations regarding current events that capture the political zeitgeist and subsequently spread virally through the internet. But the game, Start a Revolution, is the core of RLF's online activities. Due to the gamification of the revolution, the game transforms players from couch potatoes into activists within 5 weeks by offering a prize product that cannot be bought, the strictly limited Adidas RLF sneaker. With just 3 pairs available in the world, it makes the hearts of gamers and style aficionados beat faster. Users generate their own content in the game and grow into a critical community, which also makes them compete with each other by following the principles of capitalism. They continue developing the story, independently organize protests, and conduct ad-busting during the 2013 German parliamentary elections. Everything that happens around RLF is recorded by a film crew. Produced for Arte and ZDF, a subsequent mockumentary aims to place RLF into a critical perspective with other protest movements like Occupy. Prominent intellectuals such as the French human rights activist Stefan Essel, Occupy initiator Carla Lassen, Benetton photographer Oliviero Toscani, or Femen founder Ina Cherchenko reflect on RLF's subversive project. On another level, the film continues to follow the growing conflict between Friedrich and Slavia that ultimately reaches its climax when Slavia sets a freshly arrived container of 10,000 new RLF sneakers on fire, thereby destroying RLF's economic basis. The shareholders of RLF also follow Slavia's example. The winner of the Start a Revolution game, that is, the proud owner of the RLF sneakers, burns his trainers and posts the corresponding video online. But this is not the end of RLF. Even though the closing credits of the mockumentary show a sequence from Slavia's casting video revealing Slavia as an actress, Friedrich von Boris remains the driving force behind RLF as its managing director. RLF, the acronym of which also stands for Real Life Fiction, is the first transmedia project to trigger a political debate, integrate real products into a story universe, and turning a fictional plot into an ongoing movement.